Hey guys, Wells Knight here, bringing you another brand new episode of Design Tech. And in today's episode, we are finally going to be using this mod pack for what it was intended for, and that is we're going to be starting a big building project today. But before we do that, there's one thing that I want, and that is some of these travel anchors and a staff of travel. But I need a Ender Crystal. So we need a Soul Binder, a Vibrant Crystal, and an Enderman Soul. Let's see. Oh, I've got a Soul Vial right here. So the Enderman Soul should be very easy to get. I'll just pop into my Enderman farm real quick and sneak him in. And I think I have a Vibrant Crystal sitting, yep, right there. Beautiful. That will make this much easier. So, we'll come into here, go to our Soul Binder, and there we go. As soon as that's done, we should have a super fancy Ender Crystal. There we go. And we can use that to make the Staff of Traveling, which will essentially allow us to teleport and cover long distances in a relatively short amount of time, which is going to be really useful. So, let's take a look here. It's dark steel, and there we go. We should have all of that. I also am going to need a few of these travel anchors, and I should have everything to make four of those as well, because I spent a little bit of time between episodes making some pulsating crystals. Not super difficult to make. So, I think we're good. Now, as far as this thing goes, I believe I can put it, like, right here. This thing is already filled up. And then all you have to do is look at it, and bam, that's it. Pretty easy, right? Pretty straightforward. Let's call this main base entrance. We'll just call it main base. And no? Main base? Public. It shouldn't matter. How do I? Oh, there we go. Okay, so there's our main base. Now, I don't know what the range on this thing is like. It looks to be quite a ways. How far? Okay, so right about there is its limit for travel. Okay, that's good to know. That's good to know. And as soon as we step inside, I have a wireless charger that will recharge my staff of traveling. So, the next step in our master plan is to figure out where we're going to build this project. And what I want to do is I want to start work on something pretty big and fancy. And I'm thinking maybe right down in here in this snowy area would be kind of a cool area for it. And that's basically straight this way. So let's take a look. Can we by any chance still see the main base thing from the slime island? Not quite. That's a pity. That's too bad. Oh well. Can't. Okay, so we can see it from here. And that's about the limit right there. So let's say right about here on the beach, maybe? Is where we'll put the next anchor? Yeah. Yeah, like right about there. And that should work. And we'll call this one checkpoint one. And then we only need two more. Or in fact, we probably only need one more. Because I bet we can get from there to all the way up here in one teleport. Ooh, maybe not quite. Okay, not quite. That's all right. We'll put one right here. And we'll call it checkpoint 2. And then we'll put one way up at the top of the mountain, which we will call, how about right about here? That looks like a good spot for it. And we'll call this one Castle Base. So now I should just be able to poof around like so. And get back and forth between my base and the castle. I think, though, that I also want one more that will go directly in front of my ME system right here. And they're not super hard to make. So, let's see. We need pulsating iron. I don't think I have any more of that. Okay, that's easy. Let's go make some. We'll just take a stack of those. And we'll take a stack of ender pearls. There we go. And actually, you can go. You guys can go away. And I'm going to throw those into the alloy smelter, which is hiding over by my quarry. Now, we're pretty much at the point now where we have everything we need and then some. We've got pretty much infinite resources going. We've got an ender quarry set up. I also set up an ender quarry in the Nether so that we could get quartz in huge quantities. So, I mean, at this point, we pretty much have everything we need, which is great. That means that we can now focus on building rather than getting set up and getting ready to build. So, I'm very excited about that. Let's go and, wait a minute. Let's make one more of those. Make another travel anchor, close that off, and I'm just going to put that thing right here. It won't exactly fit the floor, but that's all right, and we'll call it ME system. So now we can teleport straight from here to the door, and that'll just save us a little bit of time rather than running around inside the base. Now, for our build, what are we going to need? Well, we're going to need all sorts of stuff. I think we're going to need a fair amount of cobble. And I think we're going to need a fair amount of smooth stone as well. In fact, I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and fill up a backpack. Like, for example, the white one, maybe? Yeah, let's fill that up with cobble. Because it's not like I'm going to run out of cobble anytime soon. There we go. That should be plenty of cobble. Let's also grab a bunch of spruce. I've got tons of that as well now, thanks to our tree farm that we set up last episode. And we'll just grab a little bit more of that, enough to fill up that backpack. And then last but not least, I'm going to grab a bunch of smooth stone as well. And the best place for me to grab the smooth stone from is probably right over here at these deep storage units, where the ender quarry is depositing all of it. So we'll do that, and I'll fill up the purple backpack with smooth stone. And that should be basically everything we need, at least to get started. So, we'll go there. There it is. Look at how fast that is. That is awesome. Man, that is going to save me so much time. I think I will probably need to make a flux capacitor, though, so I can recharge it. But for now, this should do. So what I'm thinking is it'd be really cool to build a castle, because I haven't built a proper castle. Not counting Twitch, because I built one on Twitch, but not counting Twitch, I don't think I've built a proper castle in any videos at all. So that's what we're going to work on here, and we're just going to kind of get the real basic stuff done today, like laying out kind of an idea of the foundation and some of that kind of stuff. We're also going to have to do some terraforming, flatten a little bit of the area here and there. Otherwise it's just not going to work out very well. So let's get to doing that. And we can just take our super shovel. And there we go. Now, I don't want to flatten it too much, because I want to build the castle kind of around the landscape. I think that'll look really nice. But at the same time, I don't want it to be, you know, filled with crazy little goofy things that are going to get in my way. So we're going to kind of compromise in between, and we're going to do what we can. And I think it might actually be faster to use the shovel, just because I don't have to deal with the snow and the plants and stuff like that on top. Although if I was going down multiple levels, then the excavator would definitely be faster. The other thing that I want to use is this super awesome magnet. I don't know if you guys have seen this thing yet. I know I've had it for at least a couple episodes. I just haven't really shown it off a whole lot. This thing is from Ender.io, and it is super awesome. It basically just makes items fly to me, and it runs on power, so as long as I keep it charged, I never have to worry about going to pick up my items. They just come right to me, which is really, really nice when you're mining or when you're doing stuff like this and you don't want to worry about having to go pick stuff up and all that kind of stuff. Look at it just fly. Look at that. That's awesome. All right. Now, finally, I also built a new hammer, which is basically just a plain old hammer that has as much haste as I could put on it and then Fortune 3. And that way I can quickly mine quartz and stuff like that. So we're off to a pretty good start. I think the first thing that I want to do, the first thing I want to do is get rid of all this stuff. That's the first thing I want to do. The second thing I want to do is I want to start kind of laying out the foundation here. So we're just going to take some cobble and just temporarily, I'm going to kind of lay this out a little bit. So what I'm thinking is this will be the main level of the castle, and maybe right about, let's see. How big do we want our towers to be? Probably like that, I think. That should work. So those will be the size of our towers, and then we can kind of clear some of these out so we can get a better idea. So we'll have one tower, and that one should work just fine, going straight down like that. Then, let's see, we're going to go... One thing that I didn't consider, though, I think I actually want the towers to be bigger than that. I think I want 5 wide towers, or 5 wide at the little point that comes out. So let's start back here, maybe. We'll go 5, and then they would come like that, and then... No, that's going to be way too big. I think the 3 wide is about the right size for what I'm going for here. But the problem is going to come in with the walls. So maybe what we'll do is we'll kind of work around that a little bit. That's tricky. Let's just experiment with circle shapes here. What if we just did something like this? How's that look? That is way too boxy. So if we did that, that's going to end up being too diamondy. Is diamondy even a word? I don't think diamondy is a word. So yeah, I guess we're going to have to go with the three wide, which is essentially a 5x5. And I guess that's okay. I was kind of hoping to mix that up a little bit, but that's all right. So let's see here. We'll go 1, 2, 3. Get out of there. 3. Like so. And like that. And I think that should work for one of the towers. And then we'll just kind of have to plan out where the walls are going to go. Because I don't want the walls to line up directly with this. I want there to be a little bit of an indent, like so. And then these will represent the top parts, of the parapets, the parts that are raised on the wall. And like so, we'll just kind of form out our towers. So it'll look something like that, I think. And that looks pretty good. Now let's go ahead and take a little bit of a nap here. And then we can look at some of the other options. Let's see. So how far do we want our tower to go? Or our castle to go, I should say. I think we want it to come out this way for sure. And then do we want three towers here? I think, well, let's see. Let's look at our landscape. Our landscape, it extends over here. Is there any way to get up here that actually makes sense? Maybe down this hill. I might actually turn these clouds off. In fact, I'm going to do that. Clouds off. There we go. So let's see. What would be the way to get up to this castle that actually makes some sort of realistic sense? I don't know if there is one. Just kind of looking at this, I don't know if it's even possible to actually scale this mountain. From a realistic standpoint, anyway, maybe we could make a path that kind of winds up like that, or comes up the mountain here. So I think this is probably the best spot for a gate, like right in here. So then we can say this is going to be the gate, and this will be another tower. Derped that one up. There we go. So we'll have a gate right there. I'm thinking that gate needs to be a little bigger, though. I'm thinking that's not going to be big enough. So maybe what we'll do is we'll kind of stick this out another 2 blocks, probably, I think is, or maybe we'll even make this like 5. What's a good, I think 4 is about the max of where I would want to go. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So here, and we'll do something special right there, I think, as far as like maybe a gatehouse or something along those lines. I don't know yet exactly what I want to do with this castle. I don't really have a plan for it. I certainly haven't gone into a creative mode and like really played around with stuff yet. So, I mean, at this point, it's very, very open to what we might do and what we might not do. There's a lot of different things kind of running through my head at this point. Lots of different ideas. And we'll just kind of have to watch as it takes shape. Now, do I want this tower to come out over here? Or do I want the whole castle to kind of... This is going to be a little derpy right here. I can just tell. Maybe what we'll do is right here we can build another tower. That might work. So we'd have a little wall like right there. And then it would come back out over this way. And then, it still won't line up if we do that, will it? Having this gate as 4 is problematic. I don't know. I think what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to figure out kind of the layout of the castle and stuff like that between episodes. And I'll probably also get myself a battery for that super awesome staff of traveling that we made. But I'm going to get this figured out between episodes, as I said, guys. And when I come back in the next episode, then we'll have it all figured out and we'll be able to get right to actually really building the castle. So, guys, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. But otherwise, guys, thanks for watching. And I'll definitely see you next time.